Okay, we're on. So, all we're going to do with this sky, you can see we've got this nice, area through here with these kind of wispy clouds, right? Mm-hmm. And so we're wanting to get that effect. So we're going mostly for the effect, not whether it's going to. Can y'all see? Can y'all see anything? Not whether it looks exactly like this sky, but you know that kind of day. And there's actually, I've cheated y'all because there's actually a little sunset right over here that I cropped out. But you know, get a little of that color that shows the time of day. Okay, so I suggest, you know, there's more than one way of going about this, but I'm going to suggest that you pre-wet your paper because I'm walking you through what I think is the safest way to go about this. Okay. So you need a scrap that's about this size at least. You know, don't try to do this on a postage stamp. You'll not discover anything. And then we're going to get some cerulean because... Is that... Oh, yeah. Okay. Oh, that's right. I forgot because... Okay. So, this is still shiny. And I've got some cerulean that is medium soup. Tomato soup thickness. I don't know. So I'm going to make some strokes in here. Oh, well, that is quite a bit. I'm making some strokes in here. They're kind of along the lines of this. At least it worked last night. Ugh. Okay, paper towel and clean brush. And let's see what we can do with this, because that's not looking too good. I'm wanting to pull some color down through here. Cerulean is pretty soft, but it does stain. It stains in a different way than the staining colors. It's hard to explain, but I think that it will be pretty good to work with. So we're going to make, let's just pull some of that down this way. And then, oh, well, we need some wispy clouds. So I'm going to take a little bit of, new gambage. Yeah, and a little more of coral. And real thin. Let's just see. Oh, I think I want a little more yellow than that. Oh, that's pretty strong. That's a lot darker than what I wanted. Let's see. And I need a little bits of that up in here.
Which red did you use?
Coral. Quinacridone coral.
Coral.
So here I'm pulling this up. And you can do a whole lot of subtractive work with this as long as you got your paper pretty wet. See, I could pull this up. I might need a lighter area in here. There's a place here, for instance, that's pretty light. None of this is white, but it's pretty light. So maybe I'll add some water in here. The part of this is that you can play with it, and these are some of the ways you could play with it to try and get the result you want. So where I put water in, now I'm taking the squeezed out brush and I'm pulling some color up, and that's kind of working. So I want this, I'm picking up just a tiny bit of blue because I don't want this to be entirely that nice peach color. I love peach color. So, but I'm looking to do things a little bit like that. Maybe I want some more cloudy areas up in here. And I can add some water, squeeze my brush out, and maybe pull up some lighter areas in here. And just kind of look at the picture and see what kind of wispy things happen, you know, in a cloud. And try to kind of imitate it. Again, don't worry too much about exactly getting it. You just want that kind of feel. So after you practice, I'll just go ahead and do this. Or I'll do part of it or something. Maybe I'll divide this. This is so big that maybe I'll divide it into two areas to give myself a little bit of room here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to wet, and I'll get it wet on in behind where I've got the tree line. But remember to do your practice first. And I'm going to tilt it just to see how wet I got it. Okay.
When you say behind the tree line, does that mean I'm going over?
Over the tops of the trees. A lot of this is going to have sky showing through, but we're just going to have to tint it a little bit later. So I've got this. Now let's see. There's really only one place on this where the color is really strong. And you don't forget that you can always, if you don't get it strong enough or quite the way you want it the first time out, when it's dry, you can use your Mr. Magic sponge and do some lifting. You can also add some more color in. So think of this as your first swipe at it, knowing that you're probably going to want to fine tune it later. So I don't have enough paint out here now. So I'm just taking this area right up in here. But you're going to get these nice soft edges, and it's wispy.
Gosh.
It's a good thing I'm not running for public office. All right. Now that's much better than the first one I did. So, I'm pleased with myself. All right, so now, and you notice everywhere I stop, I've got one of these little bloomy things. So we definitely have to get rid of those. Just come back the other way or through here, or maybe I could have applied it starting here and ending at the top rather than the direction I did it in. Oh, this is pretty decent looking. This is more cloud-like, I think.
You just needed your practice.
Yeah, I just needed to warm up. Well, you know, it does help to warm up. It really does. So let's tell you what. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to add a little bit of blue down here. Just a little. This cloud is going down this way, and this one is going that way, which I don't think it's important which way you make them go. You know, as long as you don't put a tornado in there, it's probably fine. So let's take a little of this peachy color. I kind of want to not make it too strong. And I'm going to leave a little more white. I'm going to be better at leaving white here. Oh, I think I ran into dry paper there. Okay, so, you know, this can come back in behind here. All right, so pretty decent. So then what do I do? Now I'm going to wet the other part without disturbing this, because I'm going to have a white streak coming right through there. Just add some water, and when I get right over here, I'll add a little less water. I'll be a little more cautious with it. There. So that way, see, I don't have to handle it all at once. We could, especially on a humid day like this. Yeah, you could get away with that, but... Oh, I was gonna try stroking this way. Oh, that's much better.
Ooh. Look. I see you almost fell over the backing up.
Oh. I thought I did something. You know? So, you're right. Something like that. I don't want it to look too streaky. Oh dear. Yeah, we need to come over here a little bit. I'm keeping it real light there. See, I'm just playing with it. And these clouds, they move every few seconds anyway. So if your clouds don't look like those clouds, what the heck, you know? But you're just going for that wispy, soft feel. And I'll go ahead and get a little more, a little less pink there. Here. What I don't want to do, because I want to keep this from getting dull, I don't want to get all three colors laid over each other that much. Here, I put some blue in, and there was a little bit of yellow in this, but not much. If you start layering blue, yellow, and red, you will come out with gray skies, which, you know, would be today, wouldn't it?
So, well, there is that.
There is that. And the other thing is, when this is dry, I could do this, wait and do this when this is dry, which would be smarter. But I could pull in, you know, because there is a little bit of this color. It doesn't just go from blue to peach. You know, it has, these other clouds have a touch of that in them. But probably the better way to do it is to do this much, get it dry, and then we'll come back and glaze and play with them a little bit more. Okay? So go do that stuff. All right. Now, you could use any brush, probably. But if you happen to have something like this at home, this might be really useful. Yes. Poor cat, too. What we're looking to do... Whoop. Now that I'm on camera, I probably can't make it work. I want to get a few places like that. That's just not as wet as I want it. Okay, like that. And then I'm going to come in with a littler brush. And I may make some adjustments here. I may make a lot of adjustments here. That's the outside edge of the tree. Is what I'm attempting to do. And hopefully you will also have some masked spots in here that'll make some other things. Someone showed me this and she did a better job than I'm doing. But you can, and so I want y'all to play with this possibility. Now here I'm adding some extra things because I'm not happy with it. But see, that's kind of the outside edge of some of these trees.
Do we have to ruin a brush to do it?
No, you do not have to ruin a brush. In fact, I didn't ruin a brush. And you might find better ways of doing this or do better with a different brush. You might could do a sea sponge. I've done that with people before and that worked really well. In fact, I actually think I prefer that to this. In fact, I do prefer that to this.
You want a sponge?
Do you have a...
I think I do.
I don't have one anymore.
All right, go. So now we have a sponge. And I'm picking up color on the sponge. And I want the color to be... I'm actually using a certain amount of pressure. It just depends on your sponge. But there, I've got a nice edge for my tree. And then I'm just going to add more color in as we come into the center. And I still am not totally happy with that, so I'll just add a few other little bits or darken an already wet spot. and as we come in, and then our center of our tree is here, okay, which we're also going to do more than one layer of color here, but yeah, that makes a really nice edge. So yeah, if you've got, and in fact I think I have some pieces of some at home, if you've got some sponge, you might practice a tree or two and look at your photo and just practice making a tree or two at home, okay?